Good morning, students. I am English teacher Anubha Chatterjee. Today we will start a lesson from your book, The Hornbill. It is a very, very interesting story about a businessman who undertook a voyage to duplicate the fleet that Captain Cook did some 200 years ago. The name of the chapter, as you see, is a really a big sentence. We are not afraid to die if we can be all together. This sentence was said by a 6-year-old son of the businessman. His name is Jonathan. The chapter is written by Gordon Cook and Alan Creech. So the narrator in this story narrates what happened in the voyage that he wanted to undertake and complete the fleet that Captain Cook did some 200 years ago. And you all may know who was Captain Cook. He was an explorer who went around the world some 200 years back. Now let us see what happened in this story, which is a very, very interesting one. It was on in July, the month of July 1976, a 37-year-old businessman, his wife Mary, his son Jonathan, 6-year-old, and his daughter Suzanne, 7-year-old, undertook the journey. The businessman was very, very interested in this voyage. For the last 16 years, he spent all his leisure time in preparing the ship for this great journey. He spent every moment of his time making the ship for the journey, and he tested it again and again in the roughest possible weather of the England sea. Now it was their time to departure, and they started from Plymouth, England, towards South Africa. It was a great long journey of 3 years. So they prepared the ship with all equipment. The ship was 23 meters long and 30 tons in weight with the wooden hull, and this was their preparation with all the things they needed. They took food, they took clothes. It was from Plymouth they started on July, and they reached South Africa, Cape Town, where they took two crew members whose name was Larry and Herb. One of them was an American and the other was a Swedish. These two members were taken along with them to help them on their way. But it was the 25th of December when they celebrated Christmas on the boat, and after that they celebrated the New Year. It was a fine day for them. But on the 2nd of January, something great happened. They saw some black clouds over the sky, hovering on the ship. They thought it must be a monster. But as they went forward, they saw it was not a black cloud, but a really, really very big wave that was more than 15 meters in height, and it covered their ship and almost drove their ship. The mast was broken, everything was scattered, and the ship was full of water which entered from all possible directions. It was the 3rd of January and 4th of January also when Larry and Herb, they pumped out the water from the ship like the madman. And on the other hand, the businessman, who was hurt terribly, but he did not leave the wheel of the ship. He was holding it so that the ship doesn't stray away. Then, by this jerk, their daughter Suzanne was also hurt very badly. But somehow they managed to steer the ship through the roughest weather they had ever come across. It was the 5th of January. Still, they saw the wind was having very, very high speed wind, and they thought that they may not live anymore. Their son, Jonathan, was also afraid of this, and he told his father, "Daddy, don't worry. We are not afraid to die if we are all together." Suzanne made a beautiful card for their parents to thank them for their help in this roughest weather and guiding them safely. Then somehow the businessman, he found a map and he saw that there was a small island somewhere near about. But how to find it in this vast ocean, which is around 150,000 kilometers wide, and the island was just a pin stick. So what happened? Now somehow they found a broken compass, because all the other compass had been lost. From this he somehow calculated that the island must be somewhere near about, and he told Mary to steer the ship so that he can take some rest, because since past 2 to 3 days they had not slept, neither they had anything to eat. By the time Mary brought something to eat, they all sat and had some biscuits, crackers, and some beef. And now he went off to have a rest and a nap. It was around 2 o'clock in the afternoon of 5th January. And he said, "Perhaps if we are correct, we will find the island by 5 p.m. in the evening." and it was Larry who steered the ship, and the writer told him to go to 185 degrees, and gradually they moved and moved. Finally, Susan and Jonathan ran to their father and they said, "Father, let me hug you." Both the son and the daughter hugged their father because they had done something. He had done something great. The father was surprised, "Why these children are hugging me?" And so he inquired. And he got the reply that, "You are the best father in the world, and also you are the best captain of the world." Now, they said that the island is very near and we have reached here. So, it was almost 6 p.m. and they landed on the ground after so many terrific hours, and this was the first time they set foot on a ground. And finally, they reached the island which was used by the French scientists. The next morning, all the 28 inhabitants of the island came and welcomed them, and they were safe after such a great turmoil and such a mighty storm which they had never came across. As you know, the Indian Ocean is one of the oceans which faces storm every now and then. Their boat was totally destroyed, but they were all safe. And here we come to the meaning of our lesson. We are not afraid to die if we are all together. So in this lesson, the theme of the lesson is motivation. They motivated each other and they helped each other. They stayed united with each other, and then they came and finally they won. Even after the roughest weather they ever faced, they won their journey. Though they were only halfway, they could not reach Australia because their ship was not in the condition